Hello. This is the 14th in the series, A History of Jazz. And today we start with white jazz from the very first recorded jazz band, known as the original Dixieland Jazz Band, or ODJB for short. The original Dixieland Jazz Band actually started out comprising of natives of New Orleans going to Chicago, where under the name Stein's Dixieland Band, they made a sort of success. The original group, which came to Chicago on March 3rd, 1916, and played at Chiller's Cafe, consisted of Johnny Stein, the drummer and leader, Nick LaRocca on cornet, Eddie Edwards, trombone, Alcide Nunez, clarinet, and Henry Ragus on piano. On June 16th, Tony Sparborough replaced Johnny Stein, and on October 31st, 1916, Larry Shields replaced Alcide Nunez. And it was as the original Dixieland Jazz Band, J-A-S-S, if you please, on January 27th, 1917, the ODJB came to New York and Reisenweber's Cafe. On February 26th, 1917, they made their first records, which was released on March 7th on Victor, for the Victor Talking Machine Company, number 18255. This was the first recordings made by a jazz band, recorded February 26th, 1917, and released on March 7th. It took the world by storm. There were two of their original compositions, and the very first one, and the one that created all the fuss, was called Livery Stable Blues. Thank you. the very first recording by the first jazz band, the original Dixieland Jazz Band, playing their composition, Livery Stable Blues. The other side of the record was a 78 RPM record, was another one of their compositions. And to my mind, this was easily one of the great recordings of all time. It's called the Dixieland Jazz Band One Step. Wonderful. Do you hear the ragtime influence all the way through? This was the first jazz records ever made. Livery Stable Blues and the Dixieland Jazz Band One Step, both original creations of the original Dixieland Jazz Band. This was the most important group, not only because they were the first to record, but because they were the first successful jazz band, and they became exceedingly popular. These two discs that you just heard, these two tunes in Victor 18255, sold over 1 million copies in an age where if they sold 50,000 records, they were considered doing very well. The original Dixieland Jazz Band, consisting of Nick LaRocca, Eddie Edwards, Larry Shields, Tony Sparborough, and Henry Ragus, constituted a unique group in our history. Not only were they first, and they the first successful, but they created a bunch of repertoire that all jazz bands ever since them have learned and play. And let's hear some more of this repertoire. The next selection is another original tune that they recorded, and these become premier recordings. Not only because this was the first time that they were recorded, but because this is the basis, the staple, of all such what are now called traditional jazz bands in their repertoire. Another great tune called At the Jazz Band Ball. ¶¶ how thrilling. From the first ad in the New York Herald on January 15th, 1917, it says, "Dance to the Jazz Band," but this time it's spelled J-A-S-Z. "Dance to the Jazz Band. It's new and gay, and it won't let your feet behave. First time in New York at Paradise tonight." The ODJB. Let's hear one of their original toe-tapping numbers called "Ostrich Walk." Ostrich Walk, another great original composition by the ODJB. Tea dances every afternoon from 4:30 to 6:30. Supper dances every evening from 11 o'clock to closing at Margaret Hawksworth's Paradise, the smartest, most beautiful, and most modern ballroom in America, in the new Reisenweber building at 8th Avenue and 58th Street. Decorations by Joseph Urban and Raphael Kirshner. Miss Hawksworth announces the Paradise Supper Club for those desiring the advantages of similar social organizations in Europe. Highest class entertainment every night by well-known artists. Miss Hawksworth will dance afternoon and evening with Mr. Alexander Kiam. Superb cuisine, best dance music, best dancing floor in town, and the first sensational amusement novelty of 1917, the Jazz Band. Direct from its amazing success in Chicago, where it has given modern dancing new life and a new thrill, the Jazz Band is the latest craze that is sweeping the nation like a musical thunderstorm. The Jazz Band, come exclusively to Paradise, first of all New York ballrooms, and will open for a run tonight. You've just got to dance when you hear it. Special breakfast served after 1:30 a.m. Evening dress not obligatory. So ran the first ad in the New York Herald on January 15, 1917, for the ODJB. What kind of dancing do you imagine could be done to this music? Certainly not the foxtrot, which was the latest sensation from 1914. Certainly not a waltz. Certainly not a schottische or a polka or any of the other older dances. Two-step? Not at all. What then? Why, a one-step. This was the new sensation, music featured by the original Dixieland jazz band. What was the one-step? Well, it was a couple dance, just like the foxtrot. And the man put his left foot forward, and the woman put her right foot backward simultaneously, and then the man put his right foot forward as the woman put her left foot backward, and so it went. If that resembles walking briskly, you're right. Let's listen to another one of those great dance tunes, The One Step, as composed and performed by the original Dixieland jazz band, Skeleton Jangle. Skeleton Jangle by the ODJB. As I said earlier, all of these tunes are their original compositions. More than that, though, are you beginning to catch on to the sound, the overall band sound of the ODJB? Have you noticed that they're all playing together at the same time? This was the New Orleans way of playing in bands, not having a soloist take over and do everything with the band just coming in every now and then or just accompanying the soloist. That wasn't the New Orleans way of playing in a band. but all playing together, different things. Not exactly unplanned, but certainly unwritten, and spur of the moment as far as it could go that way. The most famous, undoubtedly the most famous of their compositions, was the next one. It has become world famous, and it is a standard, and everybody plays it. Here is the original recording that everybody learned it from. It's called Tiger Rag. Perhaps the most famous and inspirational recording of all of the ODJBs, Tiger Rag. We'll be listening in future shows to more versions of the Tiger Rag, but this was the basis of all of them. This was not only their composition, but this was the standard performance, selling easily over 1 million copies. Extraordinarily popular. I hope you're noticing the band members. Nick LaRocca, the cornetist, for instance. He plays a very straightforward cornet, a very beautiful sound, but he doesn't intrude. Larry Shields is the extraordinarily inventive clarinetist, and it is he you hear, not because he's standing out as much as it was due to the old acoustical recording processes. He was right next to the horn. Eddie Edwards is a very fine and active trombonist, far more active, in fact, than most latter-day trombonists. Give a listen to what he's doing behind the scenes, as it were. Unfortunately, we can't hear Henry Ragus, the pianist. He's playing for all he's worth. And from all accounts, he was a very fine ragtime piano player. But because the recording apparatus in those days only favored the stronger instruments, the piano was sort of left out. And when you get the strong trombone and the sharp, shrill clarinet and the driving cornet sound, it doesn't leave much room for the piano to be heard. In any event, Henry Ragus died in 1919, a victim of the flu epidemic that was raging at the time. But he's there on recording, if you listen hard. Tony Sparborough, the youngest member, on drums. Poor Tony. He was not allowed to use his great battery of snares and everything else that he had. All he could use very sparingly was his bass drum, and only once in a great while, his cymbal and his woodblock was what he could use for recording purposes. Their sounds were unique, as we'll be hearing in the next few sessions, with many imitators and would-be imitators with the same instrumentation, five pieces, cornet, clarinet, trombone, piano, and drums. And yet no one ever achieved the great and unique sounds that the ODJB did. Let's listen to another original composition of theirs called Fidgety Feet. Fidgety Feet, a marvelous raggy-sounding one-step by the ODJB. I hope you're listening to the phenomenal clarinet of Larry Shields, because Larry Shields was a tremendous inspiration due to these recordings of all of the young generation clarinet players and would-be clarinet players. These were the records that were used by all sorts of young kids wanting this new sound, breaking away from the old staid popular music of their elders, and for the first time, popular music became music for the young. And it was all due to the original Dixieland jazz band. Before them, music was written for mostly adults to do their sedate dances, for their pleasant songs. Kids didn't have their own music. They had the music of the adults, which they enjoyed. But here was music very clearly for the young. First of all, who could physically last around doing these one steps? Certainly, it's very difficult for people over 30 to manage three sets, three dances lasting at least 5 or 6 minutes each of this very fast one-step music. And so the ODJB unwittingly rearranged popular music, and it became a music for the young. Their next tune is a great one. They're called Rags sometimes because ragtime was still popular in the late teens of this century. But it's not a rag. It's a one-step. Let's listen to Sensation. The sensational Sensation Rag by the original Dixieland Jazz Band. So far, we've been hearing original compositions by them. Now for a change, a tune that has become a classic because they recorded it. Composed by Tom Delaney, Jazz Me Blues. And as Sensation Rag wasn't a rag, neither is Jazz Me Blues, you'll discover, a blues. With this recording, not only do we hear the ODJB playing a tune not written by them, but also there was a change of personnel. Naturally, the ODJB attracted all of the newcomers in New York City, and all of the kids clamoring to play jazz. The original groupies, as they might be termed, of the original Dixieland Jazz Band were people like Phil Napoleon and Frank Signorelli and Jimmy Lytell and Miff Mole and Jack Roth, each one magically playing their counterparts' instruments, Phil Napoleon desperately hanging around Nick LaRocca for instructions on the cornet, Miff Mole hanging around Eddie Edwards on trombone, Jimmy Lytell idolizing Larry Shields to the point where he was going to sound like him, and Frank Signorelli hanging around Henry Ragus, and then later on J. Russell Robinson. Finally, there was little Jack Roth hanging around little Tony Sparborough, both diminutive drummers. And they were just waiting for the chance to replace one of their idols and actually sit in and play with the original Dixieland Jazz Band. They all did have that chance because the ODJB was a collective. And like most collectives, each one thought that he was indispensable to the organization, when in truth, they were all indispensable to the sound of the ODJB. And when they broke up due to dissension, by just not showing up, I'll show them, says one, by not showing up tonight. That'll show them who's the most important. And that gave one of the hangers-on a chance to join and play with the ODJB for that night. One of the luckier ones was Frank Signorelli, the pianist. When J. Russell Robinson, who took over when Henry Ragus died unexpectedly, and Robinson was a vaudeville star, and he then left the ODJB, Frank Signorelli was asked to take over the pianist chair. And in this recording of Jazz Me Blues, we hear the rest of the ODJB plus newcomer Frank Signorelli on piano doing Jazz Me Blues.
Thank you.
Jazzy Blues, played by the ODJB. Did you happen to notice the alto saxophone player adding a slight different sound? That was the virtuoso alto sax player Benny Kruger, who joined the ODJB in 1920. Once again to one of their original compositions, a lovely piece that's not too well known and not too often played today, but it's a beaut. It's called Lazy Daddy. Wasn't that lovely? Lazy Daddy, a relatively unknown piece today from the ODJB. They did something spectacular. In December of 1920, they recorded J. Russell Robinson's brand new song. In fact, they recorded two of J. Russell Robinson's brand new songs, because RCA Victor at that point, well, it was just the Victor Talking Machine Company, had a policy that was newly inaugurated of plugging an upcoming hit in addition to featuring a song. And by a strangest coincidence, both of them happened to have been written by the then pianist of the ODJB, J. Russell Robinson. You might recall J. Russell Robinson as a composer of some wonderful rags that we heard earlier in the series. Here he is now as the pianist and composer of the introducing tune. The little piggyback tune, if you will, is called Singing the Blues. The major tune, and the one that has sold over 2 million copies since its original recording of December 1920, is Margie. Margie by the ODJB. You notice the older they get, the more mellow they get, the more danceable. Not from the one step, but to the foxtrot. What a delightful tune, featuring Benny Krueger on the alto sax. The original Dixieland Jazz Band, of five pieces, not of six as it's now grown, originally comprised Henry Ragus, who was born in 1891 in New Orleans, died in New York in 1919. Nick LaRocca, born in New Orleans in 1889, dying there in 1961. Eddie Edwards, the trombonist, born in 1891 in New Orleans, died in 1963 there. Clarinetist Larry Shields, born in New Orleans in 1893, dying there in 1953. And finally, Tony Sparborough, born in New Orleans, 1897, died in Forest Hills, New York, 1969. The original Dixieland Jazz Band. And to celebrate their 20th anniversary, in 1936, they reformed, this time with J. Russell Robinson on the piano, and the rest of the other four members, Nick LaRocca, Eddie Edwards, Larry Shields, and Tony Sparborough, joined to celebrate their 20th anniversary. Let's hear them recreate the original Dixieland One Step. Original Dixieland One Step, recreated 20 years later by the surviving members of the original Dixieland Jazz Band. We'll finish today's session with their reissue 20 years later remake of their most famous Tiger Rag.